for inviting me to attend today and give my experience to the student and everybody who's attending here. When I received this invitation, to be honest with you, I was very happy because I like to give my experience to the people. Some people, you know, they don't have a vision or a mission in their life. They like just to study, end of the day looking for a job, sit in the government, and, you know, work a normal work. But for me, I don't like this practice. I like to be something unique, different than others. Today I will tell you the story of converting 3,000 dirham to 3 billion dirhams. How this happened? I started the business in 1994 while I was a student in Al-Tasalat College of University. From 1994, that time the first business was, or the first deal which I did, worth 3,000 dirham. Today I have projects worth 3 billion dirham. This has happened during 24 years, maybe 24, 25 years. So we'll start one by one and explain to you how this happened. Did not happen this by magic or support from family. My father, thanks God, still alive. People can ask him that he did not give me even one dirham from his pocket, or I did not take anything from the family. I started this from zero. And how this happened? Inshallah, one by one, we'll explain this to the people. First of all, let me tell you about myself. I'm Faisal Ali Musa. I born on 12 September 1974 in Khorfakkan. I think everybody knows Khorfakkan because it's like the Shah. I finished my secondary school in Khorfakkan. Then immediately my father decided to shift to Sharjah. That was in 1993. Then at that period my father noticed that technology and salat and all of this is very important. So he asked me to join Al-Tasalat College of University, which is next to Al-Tasalat head office in Sharjah, but now they changed it to Khalifa University. To be honest with you, I did not like college, but my father's choice. I have to say yes. Why he chose this? Because he knows that at that time, the beginning of the GSM and the technology is booming, yani, at that time, and he thinks this is the best, yani, thing. So what to do? I entered that college and I did not make very good, yani, I was not a good student at that college, yani. This is, to be honest with you, yani. Why? Because maybe it was not my field. But I learned a lot also from Al-Tasalat College of University. It was really, it's like an army campus. They are very hard, yani, at that time. Yani, I remember our the manager of the school, or sorry, the college was Mr. Salam Lewis. He is now the chairman of BIA. He was very hard, and we learned a lot from him. Yeah, to respect the time, to respect, to be a discipline, okay, in the college. Even if I was not a good student, but at the end of the day, I learned a lot from the college. So I studied and I graduated in 1998, end of 1998, 5 years as a telecom engineer. I joined Al-Tasalat in 1999, just for 1 year. And a division called at that time Cable TV, Now they changed it to eLife. And at that time I was just a graduate, and they sent me for a training, Salah, to four countries, America, Belgium, France, and Norway. I learned a lot from this training. So I was around 6 months. While I'm working in Salat and we're establishing cable TV and all of this, I receive a call from my father. He said, Faisal, you have to resign from Salat. Why? 5 years. And I completed now 1 year, now resign like this. He said, yeah, I need you to join my group. We start to be bigger and bigger, and I need you to be with me. I said, fine, okay, father, let's resign. So immediately, second day, I resigned. I told them, thank you very much. I'm leaving in Salat. That was in 1999, end of 1999. Then I joined my father. He at that time, he shipped from Khorfakkan. He used to have just a contracting company called Khalij Oman, contracting. But when he shipped here, he started to be bigger. And by the way, Al Musa Contracting built most of Sharjah University City, and more than 70% maybe. And I was one of the members of Al Musa Group who built Sharjah University City. I worked with my father at the beginning. He decided to make a furniture factory. And I start from scratch, building this factory. So I learned furniture and how to run the factories. Then he decided to make an aluminium and glass fabrication factory. Same thing, I start from scratch, planning, procurements, production, all of this. And alhamdulillah, I learned what is aluminium and how to make an aluminium window or aluminium doors. Then he decided to make a steel factory. Same thing, from scratch. Then also a crusher. All of this gave me a very good experience in planning and running the business for my father. While we are working hard in the factories, let me tell you the truth, that there was a family problem. I decided to quit the group. So I said, father, I have to leave. I cannot continue because there was a clash. Let me do my own business. That was in end of 2004. So to do my business, and I am zero at that time. I don't have anything in my pocket. I remember my bank account, it was around 300,000. And I am married and I have a daughter at that time. So it is challenging to start your business from zero. 300,000 is not a big amount. But let's see, الأرزاق رب العالمين, خلينا نبدأ. Let's start. So I decided to start. But before I tell you where I start, let me tell you the 3,000 dirham, which I mentioned to you at the beginning, I forget. While I was in your age, in the university, I need to have more money. I need to make some money. So I went to one of my friends, his father, a manager of one of its Salat branches. In 1994, and at that time, people like the serial number of the mobile phone. They need beautiful numbers. So because I have good relation with that guy, I will not say mention his name. I told him I need 20 numbers for my family. Can you give me good numbers? He said, sure, go to my father and he will give you the best numbers. I went there. Immediately, they gave me beautiful numbers. At that time, at Salat, easy if you have a relation, you can get beautiful numbers. 20 numbers, I don't need it for my family. I said, come on, let me sell it. So I went to Al Khalija newspaper. I told them I want to put advertising. الإعلانات المبوبة هذه ثلاث الصور. فحطيت إعلان. I put an advertising. It cost me around 30 درهم per day. They put for me or 3 days maybe. والله at that time people, when you get the number from Itsala, it was not very costly. It cost you maybe 400 درهم or less. يعني. I receive every day more than 100 calls. People want to buy. يعني. So alhamdulillah, immediately I sold it. Each one I make more than 3,000 dirham profit. So this is why I told you I made my first business through mobile phones or mobile numbers. So alhamdulillah, I sold it. Then I repeat the same practice with another friend and another Emirates. I like it, you know. So alhamdulillah, I did this the same and I make some money. But as a student, to make this money, it was great, yeah, to do this. Yeah. So in 2004, how was the start? Where we start? I was living in Sharjah in one of the buildings. I have a flat and an apartment. So I went to Dubai immediately. I don't know really. God sent me directly to Dubai exchange, Al-Bursa, the financial exchange. And at that time in 2004, it was booming, really booming. And if you put one dirham in Amar, tomorrow it will be two dirham. So I went there, I saw little people sitting. I don't know even how to buy or sell shares. I found some of my friends there. I told him, come on, Mr. Khalid, what you are doing? He said, we are buying and selling shares. What shares? Can you explain to me? Start to explain to me. You have to go and register, open an account, this and that, and you know, buy and sell. See what your luck. So I start, I said, let's do it. Yeah. At the end of the day, we have to make money and live. So I open a bank account an investor account in Dubai exchange. And alhamdulillah, the 300, I put all my money there. I said, let's do it. Mughamara, it's an adventure. Let's see what will happen. The 300,000 dirham within 1 month, it became 900,000 dirham. Alhamdulillah, it was Amar and booming, you know, every day it's going up. So it was very good, you know, number for me during 1 month only. Alhamdulillah, this is another success, yeah, after the 3,000 dirham. Because while I was working with my father, everything he's paying me, paying for me, yeah, for salary, my rent, my car, my travel, everything. So I'm depending on the group, family group. But after that, I said, come on, let's do something else. Yeah. Let's go and come up with an idea. Let's do something unique. But yani, without this uniqueness, I cannot, you know, live. I said, I need to make a real estate project, but a unique project. It was called Rotating City. I don't know, maybe someone heard about it or not, but Rotating City, if you Google, you will write just Rotating City, you will see maybe my name immediately will come up. At that time, there was a project in Dubai called Dubai Land. Still, this Dubai Land project is available, and they are looking only for unique projects. So I said, I went to one of my friends. I told him, listen, I have only $10,000. I need you to make for me a conceptual design. He said, for what? I told him, I want to make rotating villas. He said, what? How villa rotate? I told him, listen, I did my research through Google. There is villas in Germany. There's another villas in Belgium. People invented, and it's every 1 hour rotate. And it's similar concept to Hyatt Regency. If you go up, there is a rotating restaurant. That's a rotating restaurant, but this is a rotating villa. I said, okay, fine. Let me do it for him. So this still, this consultant, he made this concept for me, a rotating villa. It was around 100 villa and a nice landscaping and all of this. I went to Dubai Land. I told him I have this project alone. I don't have anybody. I don't have an office or a team or anything. So I make a presentation for the people there. I saw their eyes, you know, opened, and they are shocked with the idea because they are looking for new ideas. But they said, beautiful idea, let's go and continue. So after exactly 2 weeks, they gave me an approval. The project costs around 1 billion dirham. And I have only 900,000 dirham in my account. Yes, I need it for just to eat and drink. Come on, this is very difficult. So I put myself in a big problem. How to arrange 1 billion dirham and I don't have this money? I have just an idea and official approval from Dubai government. It was big, yeah, it's not a joke. So I start, you know, moving around and trying to find an investor who comes and supports me. Finally, I found someone. I explained the idea to him. I told him, listen, this is a unique project. It's called the Rotating City. You will do this and that and all of this. Yeah. He loved the idea. Sorry, I will not mention his name. But he believed in me. I told him, listen, I don't have money. I have a brain and I am a hard worker. I can work very hard. I can make this happen. I said, okay, Faisal, let's start. I told him, you open the company, you invest, and we agree together 50-50 for him and 50 for me. And I will manage the company. We start, alhamdulillah. We went to Dubai Land, and we start negotiating with them the contract, and we sign with them. 10 million square feet, okay, and we rented for 99 years. The rent was 5 million dirham. It was great, yeah, a deal for me, and alhamdulillah, we start, you know, putting the engineer, consultant, and all of this. Suddenly, Dubai government decide to cancel the project. After we pay, I remember they make a big signing ceremony for us and they announce in the media about the project and everything. It was okay, but because of some reasons, because of utility, electricity not available and all of this, they call us and they said, guys, we have to cancel the project. Wow, this is a big failure. How to rectify this again, and this investor, what I have to tell him? And he put all his money and all of that. Well, we enter into, you know, a problem. So the project is cancelled. We did not continue. So then me and the investor, we are, you know, thinking what to do after we invest and we start and all of this. I tell him, okay, just give me some time. I'll try to solve it for you. So I heard about a project in 2005 in Dubai called Jumeirah Village South. I don't know if someone hearing about this project in Dubai. It's called Jumeirah Village South. There is a circle and triangle. I went there, and at that time, this project, it was a big failure. They did the master plan many times, and investors don't like it, and nobody want to buy, and all of this. I said, let me go and see what they are doing, these guys. So when I enter there, and it's like, you know, a big thing happened to him. The CEO of the company comes to me and he starts making a presentation and all of this. and he is requesting me to buy a piece of land. There was more than 3,000 piece of land in that, between villas, ground plus four, ground plus two, unlimited buildings. So I said, fine, after you finish all the presentation, I told him I will buy a piece of plot. He was very happy and he is jumping up and down. Great, finally we have an investor who is believing in our project. So I choose a small land, ground plus 15. Okay, the cost of the land, 15 million dirhams. And I have an agreement between me and my partner. Okay, he don't want to put one dirham. How to arrange 15 million dirham now for this guy to buy the land, to design it and sell it? This is another problem. I don't know. I come up with an idea while I'm sitting with the CEO of that company. Now it's belong to Nakheel. They cancel Limitless and they put it under Nakheel. I told him, listen, I need to request something from you. He said, what? I told him, I'll buy the land. Give me the eviction plan. And I'll give you, they give us a payment plan. You have to pay this within 5 years. I'll pay this. But the first payment, which is 10%, yani 1.5 million dirham, I'll give you a PDC check, post-dated check, after 3 months. He agreed. He said, fine, let's do it. I said, great, very good. Let's we have another, you know, challenge and enter another adventure. So, the guy agreed, we signed contract, everything is legal. I have a contract, I have a receipt that I pay 1.5 million, but after 3 months. I have a fiction plan, I have everything legal. I told them also I want to go and design and start. At that time there was no RERA or any rules and regulation for the land department in Dubai or all Emirates. So as you know, it depends on your agreement with the developer. Within the first 2 weeks, I finished the conceptual design. Another 2 weeks, I finished the catalog and marketing material. So 1 month is finished. There is another 2 months left for my due date for the check. Immediately, I found an Indian investor. They call him Abu Subah. Maybe someone saw him on the TV. They bought number 5 in Dubai recently in the auction. He's an Indian guy, Mr. Raju Singh, and he speaks very good Arabic.
Yeah, yeah. Arabic.
You know him, Subah?
Yes.
Eh?
His name
is
Raju.
Yeah.
A bold guy.
I met Mr. Abu Subah in 2005. In Emirates Tower, I told him, Musubah, I have this. I designed the building, ground plus, it's a cylinder, very nice design. Ground plus 10, static building. Then the next 5 floors, rotating apartments. Still, I have rotating idea in my mind.
Yeah.
Okay, because there is a rotating building in Brazil. You can go in it and see about. I have the system, everything with me. So when I show him the design, he said, beautiful, Faisal. I believe in you and I will buy. He said, oh, great. He put on the table immediately 5 million dirhams. So still my due date, the check after 2 months. And I have 5 million dirhams from Abu Subah. Okay? And he still always, when he see the people, he said, listen, the first investor with Faisal, me, ask him. And I say this also. So he put 5 million dirham. So what I did, next day I went to Limitless. I told him, come on, give me my PDC check. I'll give you current data check, 1.5 million dirham. They are very happy because I paid before. Then I have another extra 3.5 million, which I support the company, which I established between me and my partner. Alhamdulillah, It was a very good success. Then there's other investors comes and buy and all of this. This is how I entered to the real estate business. This company, the real estate company, from 2005 to 2008, I quit that company in 2008. We start from zero, as you know, okay? Reached the value of around 1.5 billion dirham, the value of the project which we launched and, you know, announced about it. At that time, I start to quit because there start to be some problems between me and other partners, and I say, let me quit. But at the same time, I was, you know, preparing myself to do my own business. Yeah. But this is how I start. It was a clever idea that I give a PDS check, but it was, you know, if you ask me today, maybe I will not do it. Yeah.
It was risky.
Yeah, it was too much risky. The second deal with the Limitless, it was too much risky. Because they called me again, they said, come on Faisal, why come buy more yani, land? We bought land more than 770 million dirham, around 33 plots. And same thing, I tell them, come on, let me give you a PDC check, then we'll try to do the same concept. Alhamdulillah, this the same concept, yani, we did it. Some for the plot we sold it, some plot we developed it, some plot, you know. It was a great challenge, but at the end of the day, we did it. This project today, if you go to Jumeirah Village, you will see it was a desert in 2005. Yeah. Today, people living there, you know, more than 500 buildings already built, yeah, there. Yeah. So this is how the start. Let me tell you something about farm holding. Farm holding stands for my name, Faisal Ali Musa. I established this in 2006 while I was with the other partner. I said, let me establish a license, only a license, which represents me, but was not very active anymore. I start to activate the company in 2008, after I quit from that gentleman. In 2008, I did some, I established some companies, like one of the companies, it was in the events management. It's called The Bridge Event Management. We did a lot to 2013, and it was very good, you know, business. But in 2013, the business started to go down. So I decided to close it. Also, I established a block factory, Tabuk, Masna Tabuk, in Hamriya Free Zone. And in 2008, the business, in 2007, the business was great, also in 2008. But, you know, the financial crisis happened in 2008, so I decided to close it. Then, in 2008, also I established a polystyrene cup factory. Every day we produce around 400,000 cup per day. So I went to Holland to buy the production line and establish the factory. So you know, I have a very good experience in establishing factory because I did my father factory. So I established my second factory. The first one was the block factory, the second one the polystyrene cup factory. And alhamdulillah, we did very good business from 2008 to also 2013. In 2013, the business started to go down. Close it immediately. Don't hesitate. Take a decision. If you are, there is, you know, losses, immediately close it and forget it. Look for another thing. And in end of 2013, I start to see that the real estate projects start to come again to the market. You know, in 2008, the financial crisis happened. So everybody, you know, don't want to buy even 1 centimeter from even ready buildings, you don't want to invest. Plus, the name of the real estate is very bad and nobody want to invest. So I said in end of 2013, let's try. I have very small plot in Sharjah in an area called Al-Batina, ground plus 4, around 400 square meter. I said, let me build it and see how the reaction of the market, how the people will accept it or not. So I started building this. I finished the structure of the building, around 50 units only or less, even. I forget really. Immediately, alhamdulillah, an investor came and bought it all on the structure. So this means this investor going to finance me to continue with the building. I will not finance it from my pocket. It was a great, very good. Then I said, let me buy another plot and start the bigger business in real estate, especially in the off-plan projects. So I bought a plot behind Mega Mall in Sharjah, around 10,000 square feet, and I designed it. I went to Sharjah Land Department. I told them I want to do an off-plan sales. What is your rule and regulation to do this? I remember once the manager there, he said, Faisal, the market is bad. What you are coming talking about? Nobody will buy off-plan, now ready apartment, nobody buying it. Why you are thinking about this? I said, come on, we want to live here, we want to do something here. Let's start it here. So I said, okay, but there is a rule and regulation, you have to do it here. I said, come on, tell me what? He said, first of all, you have to put a bank guarantee, 20% from the value of the construction. I said, okay, great, how much? He said, check the construction cost and divide it. I want there, the cost is 20 million, 20% is me, 4 million dirham, bank guarantee to Sharjah Land Department. Unfortunately, I don't have that facility from the bank at that time to give them 4 million dirham. So I went to one of my friends in Jordan. I told him, come on, can you give me the bank guarantee and I'll give you units in the same building. He agreed. He said, come on, no problem, I give you 4 million dirham. So I arranged the requirement of Sharjah Land Department. After we launched the project, alhamdulillah, within 90 days, 90 units sold out. Alhamdulillah, off plan. It was the total sales value around 60 million dirham. I call it a Famia one. Alhamdulillah, we deliver it to the people now. It's delivered. It was just picture now, 3 people living there now. Then, you know, after we have this big success, we said, let's go and invest in another area called our Emirates, called Ajman. We bought another plot in Ajman, in an area called Al-Hulew. Al-Hulew area is a desert, and nobody even want to make a farm there. Why? It's desert at the end of the day. So we said, we have to make something unique, not like the other people, because the market still bad. And at that time, in mid of 2014, there was a lot of problems. A lot of developers, they sold unit and they run away and all of this. So same thing, I went to the land department in Ajman. I told them, I want to do off-plan sales. What do you recommend? What's your requirement? What do you need? They said, you have to do escrow account, this and that. I said, fine, let's do it. I said, I will make a smart tower. People start to ask, what is smart tower? There is smart tower and there is stupid tower. Okay, I said, no. I go back to my, you know, my study. I said, we are going to provide an application for the people and their mobile smartphones. And this application going to control the apartments from anywhere in the world. You can control your lights, you can control the AC, you can control the TV, the camera, the water heater, the curtains, everything through the smartphone. This technology is available from long time. I did not invent it. But I said, let me put technology with real estate, combine it together, come with a new product. We launched the project, alhamdulillah, within 4 months, the project is sold out. Okay, more than 366 units. The total sales more than 140 million dirham. Alhamdulillah, it was very good success in Ajman, in the desert of Plan. People love it, and this was a big boost for Farm Holding. After we launch a smart tower, we launch another tower in Ajman called Al Amra, sold out. Then we go back to Sharjah, we launch a tower called Sarqwa. It's in Jamal Abdel Nasser Street. You go there, you'll see Farm Holding there. Here we said let's combine sport with real estate. The project consists of shops plus six parking, then four podium, then 27 floor residential building. At the top of the podium, we decided to do a swimming pool, gymnasium, football, basketball court, or tennis, and all the sports at the top of this. So people love the idea. Within 6 months, sold out. More than 300 million dirham, 350 million dirham, the value of the project, alhamdulillah, sold out. Then again, we repeat the idea of a smart tower in Sharjah. We launch a project called Smart Tower 2 in Al Nahda. Same idea, application and all this. Sold out, alhamdulillah. Then we bought another plot in Ajman. We went back again to Ajman. We said, let's launch a project and combine the agriculture with the real estate. I call it Al Mazra'a Tower. Al Mazra'a Tower, it's you are going to get your vegetable for free. And organic vegetables, okay, you can go to the roof of the building. We are going to put four farms. This farm depends on a system called hydroponic system. Okay, don't need soil and don't need chemicals. So it's an organic 100%. Same thing, we launch it. People love the idea and they are buying. For the last 3 months, we sold more than 60%. Still, it's in the market now, people buying. And in the same area, in the Hilayo area, which is desert at the end of the day. But people, because we are putting unique ideas in our buildings, people come and buy. Also, we launch a project in Sharjah in Al Nahda area. We call it Art Tower. What is Art Tower? Also, there is an artist from UAE called Mohammed Al-Stad, Rassam Mashur Hamid. And we agree with him that we need you to put your pictures and or your drawings in the lobby of the building. And I'm going to make a gallery for you at the top of the building. And there will be outside Jidariyat. You can do your pictures outside of the building also. So we agreed together and we launched the project. We launched it this year, beginning of this year. During the first 3 months, 80% sold out the project, alhamdulillah. There's a few. So if you can see, always I'm trying to put ideas in my project. Smart IT with real estate. Agriculture with real estate. Sport with real estate. Art with real estate. And our new project, which we are going to launch inshallah soon, in the next 2 months, we call it Family Tower. What is Family Tower? Family Tower, we decided to make a special floor in the building. You have a swimming pool, gymnasium, kids' cinema, coffee shop, electronic games, everything in one floor. So it is an entertainment floor for the families. They don't need to go to the shopping mall or anything. They will come down and, you know, enjoy their time and go back. So it is an entertainment area. Yes, this will make our profit less, but we are different than others. Why people buying from us? Because we have an entertainment floor for free. You can come and enjoy your time here. This is next 2 months. This is the real estate sector in farm holding, but also we have another business, not only in 2016 we decide to buy a stake in a chemical company, a factory in Spain, in Valencia. They are producing a hygiene product for a clinic. They are more than 30 years old in the market, and they have a beautiful brand called Design. So we said, come on guys, we want to be with you. We reach an agreement, we start the process, everything. We launch our product, because the process of registering the chemical in Emirates is very difficult. You know, because of the terrorism and all of this, it's difficult. But finally, alhamdulillah, all our product is registered. We launch the sales last year in April. So this next April we are going to complete 1 year in sales. We have now more than 600 points we are selling in Emirates, between hotels, restaurants, schools, hospitals, laundry, all of this, alhamdulillah. And also we have a distributor now in Jordan, and we are going to put more distributors in different countries. Our competitor in this market, you will not believe it. Who is this? The richest guy in the world. Who? Bill Gates. Everyone knows that Bill Gates is doing his money from Microsoft. But Bill Gates also, with his wife, own a company called Ecolab. Ecolab, the main income of Mr. Bill Gates from Ecolab. The biggest hygiene company in the world. Alhamdulillah, in Emirates, we kicked them out and we took the contract. For me, this is a big thing. Yeah. It's not an easy job to convince the client that my product is better than his product. We did it, alhamdulillah. In 2017, this is a beautiful business. I start to think about the cinema production. We did our research on the market, and we found that the cinema is a big market. You know, Hollywood, they are making billions. But in the Arab world, maybe our brothers from Egypt, they are doing this from long time. Yeah? They have cinema production. But in Emirates and the GCC, we're not focusing on this. We're not doing the right business. There is some people tried to do a movie, and the government also produced some movies, but at the end of the day, they did not succeed, or it's not in the mind of the people yet. I decided to enter film production, and I established a company called Farm Films. Farm Films, the first film produced called Camera. It will be in the cinemas, inshallah, on 5th of April. Please come and see. It's an action Emirati movie. Okay, and I'm sure you will love it. يعني it's PG-15. يعني you are allowed to come. it's a beautiful movie. We participate in Dubai Film Festival. We said let's try our luck. This is an international award. Maybe we get it. Alhamdulillah, we have an award from Dubai Film Festival for the best producer. Alhamdulillah. So we are mainly doing three things: real estate development in Sharjah, Ajman, Ras Al Khaimah, and Dubai soon. Ras Al Khaimah, we are developing now a four star hotel in Al Murjan Island. And we are doing also hygiene product, and we are doing fan films. In future, there is more things inshallah is coming, but it's under study. Sorry, I'm talking too much. I don't know how much time I have. If you treat me like this, maybe. Well,
audience is low with your speech, yeah. So carry on. They are getting enriched.
Thank you. Okay, let me tell you some secrets of success. Yani why Faisal Ali Musa make this money and he reached to his goals? The most important thing in my belief that you have to respect time. If you are not respecting time, believe me, you'll not be a good student, you'll not be a good businessman, you'll not be a good teacher, you'll not be a good time is very important, guys. Allah قال, شو قال في القرآن؟ إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. دقيقة تتأخر ما يستوي. قاموا الصلاة روح صلي صح؟ أما تأخر معناه أنت لازم تقضي الصلاة. فالوقت in Islam even it's very important. For me, I go to my office at 9 o'clock. I finish at 6 o'clock. I am the first guy who's going to the office, and the last guy who's leaving the office. Sometimes I stay more here. But I advise anyone of you want to make a business, or you want to be a successful person, please respect time. I put this points because if someone of you would like to do a business, a small business or a big business, at the end of the day you have to work in a right process. You make this process, you are going to be a good businessman. It's not important to make a real estate, by the way. You can make small business, and from this small business you will be a big one. I tell you a story of my friends here. You know Baba Ruti coffee shop? Maybe everyone, you know this. You know the story of them? They are my friends here. They was in Indonesia. No, Malaysia. Yes. This lady with her husband, they are, you know, moving around, and they found a coffee shop. Always this, her husband sitting in that coffee shop, and the lady is, you know, doing shopping there. So she told him, why always you are here? He said, they have beautiful buns here, I eat it, and they have very nice coffee shop, coffee. It's like Karak tea here in the Emirates. She sat there and, you know, and tasted, she liked it. Said, let me meet the investor. And after she met the investor, the owner, and they make an agreement, she took the franchise, and alhamdulillah, Rasha Balhani everywhere. And you know maybe Rasha, she is a successful. So it's not to make millions or billions, it's not to the idea just to go with the real estate business or petrol business or gold business. No, maybe small ideas, abayat, cake, aisha, but you have to do it in the right way. If you do it the right way, you will be a big. If you are not doing it the right way, yeah, for example, if you make a coffee shop business and you are not respecting time, your staff coming late or you are coming late, you are not going to succeed. Second point, feasibility study. You have to do a very good feasibility study for your product, for your project. If you did not make it, you don't know if this project is successful project or not successful project. For us, always, we depend on feasibility studies from the big four auditors. They are doing a very good feasibility study. But by the way, not always the feasibility study, if you put it in the market, going to succeed. Why? Because we are human being and the life is changing quickly. Maybe today I'm talking about an idea and the technology. And the technology tomorrow, this is an outdated technology. People don't want it. It's moving very fast. So, but please make feasibility study if you are going to make a business. Teamwork. In my group, we always believe in teamwork. Always I advise my people to work in this concept. Why? Because if everyone is the left hand don't know what the right hand is doing, is you are going to be, you know, in a big mess in your business. So please think about this and work as a team. I will move quickly. Project planning, you have after you finish your feasibility study and everything, you have to plan it. You have to put an action plan how to start this business. You need to do the license, you need to rent the place, you need to put the stock, you need to bring the machines, you need to study the all this planning, put it in an action plan and do it in a right process. Employee authorities. I learned a lot from other companies that the owners, they want to be the decision makers only. They don't give their employee authorities. And I believe this is 100% wrong. For me, I give authorities for all my team, the managers, they have special authorities. The manager, they have special authorities. The people who are under them, there is another authorities. Everyone has an authority. And at the end of the day, we come and check what they are doing. So we execute, we monitor, and we check their goal. Did they reach the goal or not? So we give them authorities to, and same thing, if anyone of you thinking to do a business, please get authorities to your staff. Marketing, there is a lot of people don't know that you cannot sell without marketing. I went to some company and said, come on, why you are doing all this gifts and distributing this for the people for free? Habibi, marketing is very important. You have to spend a lot of big budget to distribute your project everywhere, either in Emirates or outside the Emirates. Without marketing, people don't know what to do. And before, and by the way, you have to update yourself about marketing. And before, we are depending on sales for the real estate and doing marketing in the newspapers. Al-Khaliji newspaper, Al-Bayan, Al-Ittihad, Al-Kalam, Kulla. Lakin, now it's not the right way. We are doing marketing through social media. One influencer in the social media having more than 3 million followers, better than all this newspaper and cheaper. And we did a beautiful business through social media influencers. They come and, you know, make some videos and put it in the social media. So marketing is very important. You have to be honest. والدي دائما يقول لي اصدق مع الناس وشاركهم اموالهم. You have to be honest with the people. People will give you their money and they will go away. Today we are selling off plan. If we are not honest with the people, nobody will come and pay his money, all his saving to you, and you know, he will go away. So this is very important. You can, I will tell this story, sorry in Arabic. يمكن كلكم تعلمتوا في المدارس موضوع ان الاسلام انتشر في شرق اسيا عن طريق التجاره منه اليمنيين اخواننا اليمنيين طلعوا من الجزيره العربيه وراحوا عملوا تجاره. احنا تروحون ماليزيا واندونيسيا وكذا تلاقون عدد كبير من التجار اليمنيين هناك وعايشين وجلسوا وكل شيء. في ناس وايد دخلوا الاسلام وراهم، ليش؟ لانهم كانوا صادقين بالتعامل مع العالم، قالوا لهم. فلما شافوهم الناس سالوا هذا منو؟ قالوا لهم هذا المسلمين، هذا اللي الصادقين كلهم مسلمين. فدخل الاسلام بهاي الطريقه بالصدق والامانه اللي كانوا يتعاملون فيها التجار اليمنيين. فنفس الشيء اذا كنت يو ونت تو دو ا بزنس يو شود بي اونست وذ ذا بيبل اند دونت لاي. Accuracy, very important. You should be very accurate. Don't accept anything 99%. If you have, for example, production or whatever, you are doing a factory and you want your product to reach to the people, make sure the quality is 100%. Don't, you know, accept less than. For me, this is very important points. If anyone of you would like to do a business, please follow this points, because some points here you're not going to read it in the books, or you're not going to learn it. يعني the doctor in I'm sure in economics or business, they will not tell you be an honest to do a very good business. This is written in that book. No, this is just from the practice you will find it. Okay, that you should be an honest, you'll make money. If you are lying and doing hunky punky things, you'll not be a good businessman. So thank you very much. I don't want to take long time. We
have to present the memento to our honorable guest, and I would like to request our acting dean, Dr. Mohammed Inara, to escort the chief guest.